The world is an overflowing gutter. It bubbles with a brine of shit and blood. And those who keep their eyes upon the heavens are the ones who will wind up face down in the mud. It's easy to speak of grand ambition. It's easy to pretend you're innocent. But lest you get distracted by the suffering of your sister being practical and trying to pay the rent, heaven has been promised to the righteous. Hell's an overpopulated pit. Purgatory's given to the dreamers, but the world belongs to those who plow the shit. There's a special place in hell for fancy talkers. There's a special place in heaven for the whores. There's a throne reserved for those with good ideas, stolen by the demagogues who wanted more. The flowers and the laces in the market are all purchased by the peddlers of the flesh. But those who bring relief and carnal pleasure sometimes serve the needs of mankind for the best. Cast off the limitations of the righteous. There are good deeds only devils can commit. Let us dance between the teardrops of the angels. For the world belongs to those who plow the shit. At last the supreme share in the particular endowment of every other creature. Taking man, therefore, this creature of indeterminate image, he set him in the middle of the world and thus spoke to him. We have given you, oh Adam, no visage proper to yourself, nor endowment properly your own, in order that you may, as the free and proud shaper of your own being, fashion yourself in the mold you may prefer. It will be in your power to descend to the lower brutish forms of life. You will be able, through your own judgment and decision, to rise again to the superior orders whose life is divine. The dead become the emperors of memory. The saints have all been eaten by the worms. The living have the right to twist the future, and the sinners all have practical concerns. They're sentinels with rifles on the border. All the pretexts of charity of worms. But let's not talk of slipping into nightmare, for the day is won by the soul.